Welcome to our DJI tutorial video, where we will guide you through the installation, activation, and operation of DRTK3 multifunctional station. Before using DRTK3 for the first time, connect it to a charger via the USB-C port to activate and charge the built-in battery before powering it on. When using DRTK3 as a base station or relay station, the survey pole and tripod kit needs to be used. Release the sleeve. Unfold the tripod and adjust the survey pole to make the tripod stable. Attach DRTK3 to the survey pole and rotate to tighten it. Press the release button to adjust the extension rod to the desired length. Release the tripod quick locks and the leg knobs to adjust the retractable legs, and then slightly adjust the survey pole to make sure the bubble of the bubble level is located within the black circle. Securely tighten the quick locks sequentially, the sleeve, and the retractable leg knobs. If you need to use it as a rover station, loosen the sleeve and pull the survey pole out of the tripod for independent use. Device activation, press, and then press and hold the power button to power on DRTK3. DRTK3 needs to be activated before using for the first time. Otherwise, it will not be able to search for satellites. The GNSS signal indicator will blink red when not activated. When used as a rover station or DJI Pilot 2, does not prompt you to activate. Connect DRTK3 to the computer using a USB-C cable. Run DJI Assistant 2 and follow the instructions to activate the device. Indicator descriptions. The three indicators located to the right of the power button show the battery level, operating mode, and satellite search status. Mode switch. Press the power button three times to switch the operating modes. While switching, all three indicators will blink green simultaneously. The switch is complete once the mode indicator changes. You can also switch the DRTK3 operating mode using DJI Pilot 2 or DJI Assistant 2. When the device is powered on, use USB-C to USB-C cable 2. Connect the remote controller and USB-C port at the bottom of DRTK3. The DRTK3 mode settings interface will pop up in the app. Select your desired mode and tap OK to switch the operating mode. In DJI Assistant 2, click Mode Switch and choose your desired mode to complete the mode switch. Base station mode is used to provide accurate data, 4 cm level positioning to improve operate precision for multiple DJI aircraft simultaneously. In relay station mode, the device can be installed at a high place and used as a communication relay to avoid signal blockage. In rover station mode, DRTK3 is used as a handheld mapping device. With the DJI Enterprise app, perform measurement tasks for control points and checkpoints, powering off and storage. After completing the task, press and then press and hold the power button to power off DRTK3. Ensure the rubber plug at the USB-C port is securely in place. Then detach the device from the survey pole and store it in the carrying case. Retract the extension rod, fold the tripod, and secure it with the strap to complete the storage. Firmware update. In relay station mode, connect the remote controller and tap the top right corner in DJI Pilot 2 to enter. Tap Firmware Update. Select DRTK3 Update and wait for the update to complete. Once finished, the app will indicate that the firmware is up to date. For base station mode and rover station mode, the DRTK3 firmware needs to be updated using DJI Assistant 2. Select the latest firmware under the Firmware Update interface and click Upgrade. Once the update is complete, reinsert the rubber plug into the USB-C port to ensure it's securely sealed. Log export. Power on DRTK3 and switch the operating mode to relay station mode. Link the remote controller and DRTK3. Tap the top right corner of the main screen to enter the health management system. Tap Manage Logs and DRTK3 Logs. In the Log Management page, select the log you want to export. Tap Upload to send the aircraft logs to the DJI server. After the upload is complete, a QR code and confirmation number will be displayed. You can save the QR code and provide this information to DJI support for troubleshooting and analysis. If you're not connected to the internet, save to aircraft to store the log on the remote controller. Once the remote controller is connected to the internet, you can select the corresponding log from local logs to re-upload them to the DJI server. Tap Uploaded. You can view the logs that have already been uploaded and tap to see the QR code and related details. If the aircraft you are using does not support relay station mode, you can connect DRTK3 to a computer, run DJI Assistant 2, select DRTK3, and enter the management interface. Click Log Export and enter the log list interface. Select the log you want to export based on the log time. Click Save to Local. In the pop-up window, choose the folder where you want to save the log and click Start Export. Once the export is complete, the logs will be saved in the chosen folder. You can provide the logs to DJI support for troubleshooting and analysis. Thanks for watching.